we have any questions?
¿Alguna pregunta, Juan?
Okay. Obey my commands. Good luck, touch gloves, guys, and let's come out and go to work.
Pretty simple instructions from Jane 80 with interpreters in each corner, and we are set for what promises to be an outstanding championship battle between Barrera and Marquez, two surefire Hall of Famers when the time comes. So Barrera's worked up a pretty good sweat, as has Marquez, so these guys know what to do to get ready, and it's time to throw down, as they say. You just feel and see the excitement at ringside here at the Mandalay Bay, and we're underway. Round one underway here in Las Vegas, and Barrera in the black trunks with the white trim. Excuse me, Barrera in the white trunks, and that is Marquez to your left with the black trunks with the white trim. Both men conventional right-handed fighters, though both will turn southpaw for strategic advantages along the way. So we'll keep our eye on that. Got to split down the middle here tonight. Can't really tell at this point. He's got the bigger crowd following here in Vegas. Body shot, middle low that time by Marquez with the left hand. No feeling out process here. A lot of intensity behind the punches from both men. So both men exhibit great defense. Nice jab that time by Marquez. Left hand, right hand combination by Marquez as Barrera snuck in a left. I'd say Marquez is a little bit more shifty than Barrera. Barrera probably has a little more power, but again, these guys are very evenly matched. Nice right hand that time by Marquez scores. Best punch of this round one. Barrera, you know, has a great job going for that right hand. Marquez has every punch in the book. Uppercut, left hand, hook, right hand. Got a good jab. Discrepancy here. You're almost looking at a mirror image of both men. But again, Barrera, the older of the two. You can't discount the fact that he has 68 pro fights to his credit. Marquez, very experienced, with 50 pro fights to his credit. But Barrera's been in a lot of wars along the way. Right hand on the counter by Marquez. Caught Barrera right on the butt. But as we said in the open, Barrera can take a shot. He's got a very strong chin. Marquez getting off first. Strong with the combination. And the left hand by Marquez. A little too quick for Barrera. That might be telling early in this fight, the quicker hands being exhibited by Marquez, clearly so far in round one. Got a right hand by Barrera. That might be a strategy of his to try to counter Marquez, who's very aggressive, and he will leave himself open along the way. Closing seconds of round one. Out of action in round one. It promises to be an action fight. There's a left counter by Barrera. Round two underway. Giving round one to Marquez on the strength of the hand speed, and he was just the more active of the two. Both these men have trained for the 12-round distance, no telling if it'll go that long. And both men have been the 12-round distance on several occasions, so that should not be a factor tonight, going into uncharted waters for either one of these guys. You see Marquez tripling the jab, following the right hand. Again, he is the sharper puncher so far in this fight. He started his pro career back in 1993. And he lost his opening fight, believe it or not, to Javier Duran in Mexico City. He was DQ'd in the first round. Don't have any more info on that. That first eight fights were in Mexico City, and he's been to Las Vegas on several occasions while Daniel Marquez has. score. Best punches of the fight for Marco Antonio Barrera. And he's stopping the momentum of Marquez there for a moment. There's a payback left hand by Marquez. Short uppercut from the inside. Marquez has been a world champion at the highest level since 2003.
Stop!
His last loss coming to Chris John. In the Philippines, traveling on the road, losing a unanimous decision for the WBA Featherweight Championship. So he's moving up in weight here to the Super Featherweight limit. Face off against Barrera. Barrera's got good defense as well. Still has his reflexes, no doubt about that. Both men took the scales. Under the 130-pound limit, 129 on the card for Juan Manuel Márquez. Pound-lighter, 130-pound Barrera at the weigh-in. There's been put weight on since that weigh-in, and a nice round two for Marco Antonio Barrera. Finding the rhythm, it's Marco Antonio Barrera. Now three underway. Talking about when he started way back in 1989, had his first taste of major championship action in the super bantamweight division back in 93. Super bantamweight champion in the WBO for about 7 years, vacated that, moved on to the WBC super bantamweight title. Another nice shot that time. And he's been in over 20 World Championship fights, Marco Antonio Barrera. Stiff jab by Barrera. Got a little rhythm. He is beating Marquez to the punch now. The referee won't have to do much in this one. Nice left hand that time by Marquez as he backed away. Both men fading, trying to find that opening. Fighting so far. Marquez with the faster hands doing some damage on the inside. You might want to try that a little bit more. He's got the quicker hands there on the inside and the really negating the rhythm that Barrera has built up over the last round and a half. Jumping in with the deep right hand, Barrera. Marquez back to the body. Barrera, double jab, fires the right hand and the body comes up short. And these guys are great defensive fighters as well as power punchers. There's a good body shot that time. You throw those body shots early against a veteran like Barrera, you're like putting money in the bank for later on in the fight. Put a deposit in, it might pay off at the end. A lot of changes in momentum so far in 2 rounds and 2 minutes here in this one. Scheduled for 12 here in Las Vegas. Barrera's punches are a little slower than Marquez. You can notice that. Marquez, the counter left hand, misses by the nose of Barrera. Change of jabs now. These guys have known of each other for many, many years. And here they are with a lot on the line. Barrera showing some movement for the first time in this fight. Side-to-side movement. There's a left hand to the body, but Marquez counters nicely with a combination. A low blow that time. Knocked down low, actually, by Nady. We come to the conclusion of round three, scheduled for 12 in Las Vegas. Wobbled him a little bit. I think it knocked him off balance more than hurt him. Here we go, round four. I call the last round even, so I've got an even fight through 3 rounds. 1 round apiece and 1 even. Action has been exclusively in the center of the ring. Neither man has gone to the ropes or a corner. Jab by Barrera. Gets through the guard of Marquez. Right now, if you're waiting for somebody to pull the trigger here, your counterpuncher, you're going to be waiting. Both these men are great counterpunchers. see him there just waiting for the other to make a move. And if no one makes that first move, they're just going to be sitting there fainting and dodging and not punching. You see right there, neither man wanted to open up because he knows the other is going to counter. Jab by Marquez. And these guys, I think, have figured out each other's styles here in the first three rounds, so tactics might change. Body shot by Marquez, diving in and holding the back of his head, one of the only clinches of this fight, as Barrera held on. Punches have really slowed here in round four. Not as much punching going on. Marquez doing most of the leading right now. Nice jab that time. Made Barrera look silly that time because his jab took the jab away from Barrera and he missed by a yard. If you're the corner of Barrera right now, you think the man is just giving this round away. He's not punching. He smiled at Marquez that time, but again, Barrera not punching. There's a body shot by Marquez. He's just about giving this round away. Nice shot that time by Marquez before Barrera could act and react. Again, Marquez looking like he did in round one with the faster hands. Diving in with the right hand, Marquez comes up short, left hand buzzing and scores. A couple lefts blocked by the arm and shoulder of Barrera. Uppercut by Marquez. Back to 2003. There's a nice right hand by Barrera when he was TKO'd by Manny Pacquiao in San Antonio, Texas. Lost a couple DQs, also lost a unanimous decision, but Barrera's been down one time, and that was to Manny Pacquiao. Nice right hand. Marquez now aggressively going after Barrera as we come to the end of round four. Good round for Juan Manuel Márquez. Video boards and they reacted, but not as powerful as it could have been. Good defense that time by Barrera, even though he did get hit. Round five underway here in Las Vegas for the WBC Super Featherweight Championship. Right hand by Marquez comes off the mark that time. You know, we talked about Barrera being down and knocked out by TKO just one time in his career to Manny Pacquiao. Checking the record of Marquez, he's never been TKO or knocked out. Two unanimous decision losses. One to Chris Jones, one to Freddie Norwood back in 1999. As we mentioned, the DQ loss in his pro debut back in 93. Good right hand that time by Marquez. We see the left hand of Barrera. Getting it drift a little lower than it was earlier in the fight. Both men unmarked. Neither man has been down. Barrera eats another right hand from Marquez. There's a left jab that time by Barrera that scores right on the nose of Marquez. Good body shot. Right to the breadbasket that time by Marquez. Earlier in this fight, Marquez, when he was on the inside, did some good damage. Hasn't gone back to that attack yet. These men, neither man has taken a step back. They've gone side to side a little bit. Barrera gets pushed back, just as I say that, by that jab. Tempo that this fight has fallen into is Marquez's tempo right now. Barrera needs to do something to change the momentum. Close rounds, but Marquez taking the advantage, throwing more punches, and connecting more. Right on the button that time, Marquez in the forehead. Again, not flush, but he did score with that right hand. Cut that time. Nice punch by Marquez. And Barrera's got just a super strong chin, as we told you at the beginning of this broadcast. I mean, he literally has a hard edge. Left hand that time by Barrera. Some footwork here in this round. Marquez was walking in behind a combination. Didn't have the best balance that time, but he scored, throws out the jab. Again, who did the most in this round? Marquez, the busier of the two, throwing more punches, connecting with more. Neither man getting hurt as round five comes to a close in Las Vegas. Nice jab that time by Barrera. And a closing section to the right. Watching the corners, listening to the corner of Barrera, more than one person talking. And round six is underway. I've got Marquez on top. 3-1 with one round even. He's taken the last two rounds on my unofficial scorecard. Las Vegas, Nevada is the site. His WBC Super Featherweight Championship. Manuel Marquez to the left in black and white trunks. Marco Antonio Barrera, the silver trunks. Now he's to the left. Two all-time legends of the sport, squaring up. Marquez really hasn't changed his attack at all. He's got his hand still up, still bouncing his step. Barrera a little more plodding in this fight. Nice job by Barrera, beat Marquez to the punch. Jab by Marquez off the gloves of Barrera. And they lock up for one of the few times, but they split up just as quick as they locked up. Body shot by Barrera, buried by the elbow of Marquez. Nice job defensively, uppercut by Marquez. Now one question we have coming into the fight was the conditioning of Marco Antonio Barrera after all the wars he's been through. He looks pretty good. Just not as quick as Marquez, who is in excellent condition, and as we say, the younger man. Over right hands by Barrera, a jab. He needs more of that. He needs to let his hands go. Marquez throwing more punches, and by virtue of that, landing more. There's a nice jab by Barrera, starting more. Left-right combination by Marquez, coming right back. At that distance, he needs to be throwing that jab. Again, you get a little older, you gotta, your body's gotta tell your fist to do it. Doesn't happen as naturally. Uppercut that time, body by Barrera, overhand right by Marquez. Punch on the clinch that time. It did not score. No warning from the referee, but a nice uppercut there by Marquez. Closing seconds of this round. One hand by Marquez. Nice right hand that time by Marquez. Catches Barrera on the way in. Halfway through this championship fight. For the squared circle, the drama that unfolds. We have 6 rounds to go on the card right now. Don't know if it'll go that long. Marquez and Barrera into the second half of this fight. And over the first half, I think Marquez has really established that he is the general in that ring. He's showing the better ring generalship, faster hands. Barrera's going to have to change his tactics, mix something up, or it's going to be a long night for one of these two legends, Barrera. Conditioning shouldn't be a factor. These guys train like warriors. There you see the left eye of Marquez. Can't see it when he's seated on his stool, but it is swelling up, and when you've got some swelling, you also increase the risk of a cut, so we'll keep an eye on that left eye of Marquez. Marquez on his toes, dancing. Barrera trying to measure him, and unleashes a wild right hand, way off the mark. Body shot, short body shot by Marquez. Right to that left rib of Barrera.
Stop!
Coming left hand that time by Marquez. Off the glove of Barrera. Again, he's a great defense. Both these guys are great defensive fighters. seems that the people's choice here tonight is Marquez. Big right hand. Buckle the legs of Barrera. He's a warrior. He fights right back, but his legs buckle. Best punch of the fight. And he's in a little bit of trouble here. Left hand that time by Barrera, trying to keep Marquez off. Another punishing right hand. Marquez teed up that right hand here in round seven. Up with a body shot. Unleashing the arsenal, Marquez on Barrera. Now that right hand, moments ago, changed the complexion of this fight. Another combination, another big right hand. Barrera hurt again up against the ropes. Trying to hold on, Marquez senses he can finish it here. Barrera, though, the veteran, battles back. Hasn't had to hold on yet. Recovering here, somehow recovering from those powerful right hands. Straight left that time by Marquez. Another left and a third left, this time a hook. Huge round for Marquez here. Round sevens have been a big one for him. Barrera holding on. He is exhausted. He's taking a beating here in round seven. Right hand by Barrera, he's got something left. And down goes Marquez. And Barrera hits him when he's down. Could be disqualified for that. Now, the referees say no knockdown, but he hit him while he was down. Marquez is rocked. I think it was a knockdown, and I think he hit him when he was down. And he's going to take a point away. This is a good call. Though unpopular with some of the fans in Vegas, he hit Marquez when he was down on a knee, but I think it should have been called a knockout before that punch. What a turnaround. That would give Marquez a 10-8 round in that round. There you see a cut on the left eye of Barrera. It's a bad place, but it's not a bad cut. Marquez was dominating that round. There's the right hand from earlier, the big right that wobbled Barrera. There you see him. His legs went rubbery. And there is the right hand by Barrera that put Marquez down. His glove touched the canvas. His knee touched the canvas. No doubt about it, it was a knockdown. But the referee called it a slip. And here's the deduction for a point. Boom, that is possibly cause for disqualification if Marquez could not have continued. In any event, it scored is a round for Marquez, even bigger than it would have been. Round seven, the turning point. Stop! It could be a 10-7 round, depending on how you scored it, since they did not score it a knockdown.
Don't hold it!
Marquez had dominated that round, buckling the legs of Barrera, so potentially a 10-7 round, with the point deduction, definitely a 10-8 round in favor of Juan Manuel Márquez. Building up a commanding lead as round eight is underway. Taking has finally here in round eight. Great job that time. Scores off the forehead of Marquez.
Stop!
Barrera holding on in that clinch. And that point deduction in round seven really could come back to haunt Barrera. If he can continue with this momentum, he's building here in round eight. Ducking the whizzing left of Marquez. Barrera, once again, has those quick reflexes still. The veteran does.
Stop!
20 seconds to go here in round eight. Scheduled for 12 for the WBC Super Featherweight Championship of the World. Right hand by Barrera. Another left hand by Barrera. Peppering the dome of Marquez here at the end of round eight. Another left hand by Barrera. Marquez, a little hop out of his corner, trying to get some life back in those legs. Round nine on the line.
Stop!
We have as many pro fights as both these men do. Marquez with the 50-some-odd fights, and Barrera with 20 more than that. You wonder where they hit a wall in terms of fatigue. You see the wear and tear of a fight. Neither man is showing that wear and tear right now. Look at him. Both looking strong in the ring. Nice counter that time by Marquez. There have been so many ebbs and flows of momentum in this fight. And you can see that left eye of Marquez not real clear from this vantage point, but he does have some swelling. Could not get out of the way. Thud as the punch scores. Barrera has really established the jab over the last couple of rounds. That'd be a good weapon. Follows it with the right hand. Push off by Marquez now. That's really not too bad over the left eye. Marquez hasn't gotten worse over the last couple of rounds. Bernard Hopkins ringside talking to someone. There he is. Hopkins strategy. Can't get enough out of the execution when it comes to ring strategy. Is it Marquez now rallying behind their man? Some booze trying to drown him out. Nice right hand Barrera with Marquez up against the ropes. Time spent not punching. There's a jab by Barrera. Kind of abandoned the jab.
No.
This round. Grabbing Marquez around the waist. Advancing there. Nice left hand on the inside that time by Barrera. Marquez firing right back. Nice combination by Barrera that time. Marquez misses with a right hand. Very close round. Ball. Jab by Barrera that time. He holds on. Uppercut on the inside by Barrera. You get as much as you can behind that punch. So when you hear commentators refer to arm punching, that's the opposite of that. You take a lot of power away if you take that torso and that base out of that punch. Last round of Barrera on the stroke of the last 30 seconds. Nice right hand by Marquez, and they just continue to pound away at each other. I've got Marquez on top, 5-3 and 1 round even, but one of those rounds was a 10-8 round in favor of Barrera because of the point deduction, in favor of Marquez because of the point deduction of Barrera for hitting Marquez when he was down. Warning to Barrera that time for hitting Marquez behind the head. And he could ill afford another point deduction at this point. That overhand right there, Marquez has scored, but Barrera stayed out of range the last couple of rounds. fight here for the WBC Super Featherweight Championship. The site, Las Vegas, Nevada. Nice right hand by Marquez. Another nice right hand and a left on the inside by Marquez. Turning the tide here. On the inside, getting those punches off. Barrera not quick enough to react. Another combination. Three punch combination by Marquez. Barrera's punches becoming a little slower right now. Maybe he is reaching that point of fatigue. Barrera, multiple shots that time. The uppercut scores with a right hand by Marquez. Body shot by Marquez. Neither man is really invested into the body attack. Drop this fight. Right hand with a head scores that time by Marquez. Barrera scores a right, misses a left. Both men have been head hunting for the most part. Body shot by Barrera that time. And an overhand right scores by Marquez. He's targeting that left eye of Barrera's with the right hand. Less than 30 seconds to go in round 10. Marquez swinging wildly. Nice counter by Barrera on the inside. It's been a good round for Marquez. Despite a fast finish by Barrera, with 6 minutes to go in this championship fight. Picking up speed here. close. I think he wins. Into the 15th round for Barrera. He's very familiar. Excuse me, the 12th round. Very familiar with the championship distance, having gone 12 rounds 15 times in his career. Marquez has been the 12th round limit 7 times in his career. Overhand right by Marquez that time. Again, Barrera's got a lot of knockout power. We've seen it over the years. 42 knockouts out of 63 wins. So it could end in a hurry with Barrera's punching power. Marquez, though. Right, now there's a bad cut. Bad cut over the right eye of Marco. No, it is Marquez who's bleeding. And Barrera, both men bleeding here in round 12. Marquez's cut seems to be the worst of the two. Nice combination. Marquez firing up now that he can taste his own blood. Pushing himself midway through the final round. Nice right hand that time by Marquez for. Marquez cut, fired him up a little bit. Haven't had a good shot at that right eye yet with their camera. Marquez back to us, but it is a bad cut. And the blood just streaming down his face. But he continues to stand right in front of Barrera. There you see the shot of the cut. Marquez complained about Barrera cutting earlier. So I'm sure they'll complain about this cut being caused by Barrera. Marquez followers continue to chant his name. Barrera needs to pull lightning from the jug here. He needs something major to happen. And Marquez is going to win it, at least on my scorecard. Stranger things have happened. Nice right hand by Barrera. Never know how the judges are viewing this fight. Barrera turns southpaw in a moment. Both men bleeding at the end of this one. What a fight. We knew it would be. To the final bout, Marquez and Barrera. Crowd loving it in Las Vegas. And Marquez exulting in what he thinks is victory. Barrera feels good about his day's work. There's a shot of that cut. Hate to see that happen in the final round because that will show him from training. Barrera has a cut of his own. Opened up a little bit there in the final round. There's the face of Juan Manuel Márquez. Good sportsmanship. A lot of respect between these guys. A lot of respect. You see Bernard Hopkins. He's everywhere. He's in the background. Manly attired, I might say. Corner of Barrera congratulating Marquez. There's one of Marquez's corner men congratulating Barrera. Again, you never know what's going to happen with the judges' scorecards. Some of the rounds very close. Here's a close up of that cut. Looking back, round 7. This was a crucial moment in the fight. Marquez dominates early, wobbles the legs of Barrera. Really put on an onslaught in round 7. I thought he was going to put Barrera down in that round, but just that quick, boom! Down goes Marquez with a straight right, but here you go. Barrera punches him when he's down. Point deduction from Barrera. And this punch was not called a knockdown. This was not called a knockdown, clearly a knockdown. Both gloves touched the canvas and the punch while he was down. So I guess if you could argue the point, if Jay Nady did not call a knockdown, then that meant that Marquez wasn't down. So he didn't punch him when he was down. So it'd be interesting to hear the referee's explanation on that one. Nonetheless, it's in the judge's hands. Here's the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Mandalay Bay of Las Vegas, before we go to the scorecards, a round of applause for these two Warriors in the ring here tonight. The judges' scorecards are as follows. Doug Tucker, 118-109. Patricia Morris-Jarman, 116-111. Paul Smith, 116-111. To the winner, by unanimous decision, and new WBC Super Featherweight Champion of the World, Juan Manuel Dinamita
Márquez, wrestles away the championship from Barrera. What a fight. The discrepancy on the scorecards, a little wide, I thought, but nonetheless, Barrera disappointed. Márquez goes home as the WBC Super Featherweight Champion.